In this part, we will talk about the steps which are involved in the process of fertilization. Now, when we define fertilization in one line, it is simply written as fusion of male and female gametes to form a diploid zygote. But actually, the process is not that simple. There are multiple steps which are involved. So the first step, for understanding purpose, we are dividing it into various steps so that each and every part is clear. The first is approach of sperm. Now, how the sperm is going to reach up to the egg? This is the first part. In one ejaculate, about 3 to 3.5 milliliter of semen is deposited in the vagina. Now, this ejaculate means one time, whatever amount of semen is released, that is called an ejaculate. In that, about 200 to 300 million sperms are present. And the reason for such a large number of sperm is that they have to face many barriers when they cross the female reproductive tract. So, these millions of sperms will be helped by certain things and there would be certain barriers for them. So let us talk about what are those things which help the movement of or the path of sperm. So help to sperm. Now what are those things? Number one is the lashing movement of the tail. The sperm has a tail. In the middle piece, there is Nebenkern, that is mitochondria. So that provides energy, and with the help of that energy, the tail moves with the lashing movement. So the tail is going to help the sperm reach up to the egg. The second thing are the chemicals, that is prostaglandins. Prostaglandins are responsible for causing contractions in the vaginal part and the uterine part. But these contractions are in the reverse direction. That means from the vagina, it goes upwards up to the fallopian tube. So prostaglandins would also help because they are responsible for this peristaltic movement. So from the vagina, the movement would take place upwards. So that will help the sperms to move up. The third thing is aspiratory movement of the uterus. Aspiratory movement is sort of a suction movement because of which the sperms would be pulled upwards from the vagina. So these three things are going to help the sperms. So, or we can say they are going to provide the help in the movement of sperm. The second thing, now what is going to cause or act as a barrier? As a barrier, or what are those things which are going to provide resistance to the movement of the sperm? Number one, the thick endometrial lining of the uterus. Thick endometrium. This is when we are talking about when fertilization is going to take place. That means on the 14th day of menstrual cycle, when the egg is released, egg is going to remain in the fallopian tube for about 2 days. At this time, the endometrial lining is thick and folded. If this is the uterus, the endometrial lining is folded like this. That means the sperms have to swim through this thick endometrial lining, which provides a physical barrier. So they have to cross this physical barrier of thick endometrial lining. Another barrier is a chemical. Basically, these are acidic. Dushchar. So, acidic pH in the female reproductive tract. This acidity kills the sperms. And third thing which acts as a barrier are the phagocytes. So, phagocytes in the female reproductive tract. They engulf the sperms. So, there are a few things which are helping the sperms to move, and there are a few things which are acting as a barrier in the movement of the sperm. Now, with this help and with these barriers, only 100 sperms, only 100 sperms reach the fallopian tube. So now, the reason for such a large number of sperm production is clear. If the number of sperms produced would have been small, say 100 or 200 or maybe 1000, most of them, they die, and hardly 100 out of these millions are able to reach. So if the sperms are less, then probably no sperm would be able to reach up to the fallopian tube. That means there would be no fertilization. At the end of this chapter, we would talk about certain disorders where in males, the sperm production is less. So, that condition is known as oligospermia, or sometimes the sperms are almost negligible and non-motile. That condition is known as azoospermia. In both, the males are sterile. So, if sperm production is less, almost nothing would reach up to the fallopian tube. That means there would be no fertilization. So, here we are talking about this approach, how the sperms are moving. At what rate do they move? The sperms move at a rate of 1 to 4 millimeters per minute. This is the speed with which they are able to swim. Certain things help, certain things act as a barrier or resistance. There is one more very, very important change which is going to take place. In the female reproductive tract, when the sperms are moving towards the egg, that is known as capacitation. So let us take those changes in the sperms which take place during capacitation. The process of capacitation basically means when the sperms attain functional maturity. Sperms attain functional maturity, and this takes place in the female reproductive tract. There are two important changes which take place here. Number one, there is removal of glycoproteins and sterols from the acrosome membrane. Sterols and glycoproteins from acrosome membrane. Acrosome is the part where these enzymes are from, where the enzymes would be produced. And here is the head part which has the nucleus. So here is this acrosome which is going to produce the sperm lysates. In this membrane which is surrounding the acrosome, that means we are talking about this membrane has these sterols and glycoprotein. In the female reproductive tract, substances or chemicals are produced which remove these glycoproteins or the sterols. So these glycoproteins and sterols go and bind to these chemicals. Because of this, the membrane becomes weaker, permeable, and the second change which takes place is influx of calcium ion. Calcium ions are taken in, and as soon as calcium ions move in, the activity of the sperm increases. So these sperms become more active. That means they will be able to swim at a faster pace properly. And as the membrane becomes weak, this acrosome will be able to release the sperm lysis. These sperm lysis will dissolve the layers around the egg, then only this fertilization can take place. And that is why we are calling it functional capability or functional maturity. Function of the sperm is to fertilize the egg. For fertilizing, it has to reach up to the egg. To reach up to the egg, it has to dissolve all those membranes. That is going to take place with the help of sperm lysis. They can be released only if the membrane becomes weaker. And this process is called capacitation, by which the sperms, they attain functional maturity. That means now they have the fertilizing power. They will be able to fertilize the egg. Important thing that we have to remember here is this change in the sperm takes place in the female reproductive tract, because here these substances are produced which are able to remove the glycoproteins or the sterols from the acrosome membrane. With all these things, that is capacitation going on, certain things helping the sperms to swim, certain things acting as a barrier, 100 sperms reach up to the fallopian tube. So approach of sperm means the sperm, after being deposited in the vagina, now they have reached the egg. So they have approached the egg. In the next part, we'll talk about the next process. What's going to happen after the sperms reach closer to the egg?